The British allowed me to come to Palestine because I'd won a scholarship from the Hebrew University. But when I got here, Hadassah had just opened their first nursing course, so I signed up. It seemed more interesting.
We were very poor, but my father insisted we get a good education. He sent my two elder brothers to medical school, and that took my interest. When I came to Israel, I started working at Hadassah. They sent me to work in the burns unit.
I came to Israel from the former USSR. Thanks to Hadassah, within 3 months, I was already working as a nurse in the operating room.
I was on my post-army vacation when one of the passengers on my flight collapsed. A few people leaped up and started performing CPR. I stood there not knowing what to do. One of them stood out in his professionalism. I asked him what he did, and he told me he was an ER nurse. I looked at him admiringly and said, "Okay, that's what I want to do."
The work isn't just physically demanding, it's emotionally demanding as well. You're constantly giving yourself to others.
You have to love it. You can't be a nurse without making it a part of you.
Being a nurse is being part of a team. You have to cooperate, you have to care and look out for each other. It's impossible otherwise.
I fell in love with nursing. I learned to really see people, to look beyond a disease or an operation.
When I finished nursing school, they asked me to stay here and teach. I gained experience as a nurse by working on my vacations. A friend of mine was treating Henrietta Soult, who was already ill, and I joined her. She was amazing. Instead of talking about her disease, she kept asking about us.
The Yom Kippur War broke out. My husband was on reserve duty. I was alone. I was pregnant for the first time. I fretted. I was always in the hospital. I was on my feet 12 hours a day.
Earthquake rocked this impoverished Caribbean nation late this afternoon. A disaster of this magnitude could well be an unfolding catastrophe.
In the middle of work, I got a phone call. Come immediately and pack a bag for 2 weeks. We landed in Haiti the following day. It took us 4 hours to build a field hospital with a maternity ward, an x-ray machine, a lab. We worked on it from 4 o'clock to 8 o'clock. By 10, we were already receiving our first patients. My experience of working at Hadassah after the suicide bombings in Jerusalem proved invaluable.
A Jewish girl from the Birthright program came to us in dire need of a liver transplant in the U.S. As a flight nurse, they called me to accompany her. Everyone volunteered to help. They all covered my shifts at the hospital so I could go.
That night, I stayed on Mount Scopus instead of taking the morning convoy. I was in the middle of class when we heard the explosions. I didn't stop teaching. Things like that were common back then. At noon, someone managed to get there and tell us about the massacre. 78 friends, students, and colleagues had been murdered, including our beloved administrator, Dr. Yasky.
Soldiers came back from the front completely burned. I used humor to help them and their families. It helped me too. The horrors I saw were indescribable, but I've been a burns expert ever since. I told myself that I'd treat people for as long as I lived.
Most of the injuries were in the limbs, and we quickly ran out of the screws we used during operations. I decided to leave our secure compound on my own and look for a solution. I found an abandoned factory with some undamaged engraving equipment. I brought the equipment back to the camp and made us some screws. It allowed us to save lives until more supplies could be brought from Israel.
We built an IC unit on the plane. I was so agitated that I couldn't sleep during the flight. I only started breathing again when we reached the operating room door. We'd managed to get her there in stable condition. They could start the operation. While I was taking care of things, someone from the hospital came up to me and offered me a job there. I told them no way. Israel and Hadassah are my home.
I still volunteer at Hadassah. I'm head of the Hadassah Graduates Organization. This year, I was given the Yakir Yerushalayim Award for my work at Hadassah.
The day I left Hadassah, I cried. I'd never take care of people again. Now, as a pensioner, I volunteer at Hadassah's community projects.
I can't imagine my life without Hadassah. My kids were born here. I'm proud of Hadassah and proud to be a part of it.
I grew up in Hadassah. I started as a student at the Hadassah School of Nursing. I feel like I'm part of a big family, a circle of love and care. It's amazing that the women of Hadassah have kept this family going for over 100 years.